Mr. Ala, good evening.
Good evening.
Thank you for giving me opportunity to interview you. So tell me, Mr. Ala, tell me about your career and experience in metros and railway, and what is your current role in your company?
Okay, so thank you for giving me this opportunity to talk to you. Currently, I am the managing director of Alstom for India and Southeast Asia, which means I'm heading the full operations of Alstom in the country. And I am associated with transport since 2.5 years, but I am associated with Alstom since 37 years in the hydro and power activities before.
What is your value proposition for metros and railway industry?
I think the value, particularly in the Indian market, you need to have a reliable component, a proven component, and which is cost effective, and which also satisfies the expectations of the customer in terms of passenger experience. Because our Indian customers are really discovering the pleasure to use these public transport systems. So this dimension is also very important.
What are new trends in metro automation?
Today, there is a clear trend toward what we call the GoA4 version, which is driverless. The metro we are presently executing for Bombay is driverless, and this is clearly the trend today on the market.
What was the most challenging part of your journey till now, and how did you overcome it?
I think one area which was for us very, very difficult was the start of commercial operation of the Lucknow metro, because the schedule was extremely short. The preparation of the train could not be done as it should have been done, and it took a lot of work with our teams together with customers, but together we came out of it now.
Currently how many metro projects you are serving?
Today the jobs on which we are working, four trains, there are four in India, two in export, and we deal also with signaling for another 6 or 7 projects, and power supply for 3 more projects.
So what are the benefits gained by your client while doing business with you?
I think looking at it under the angle of the Indian customers, what I think should be a big asset for them is our proximity. Because while we are an international company which has a connect with all the experience of the Alstom over the last 150 years and the technology centers in Europe, we are very, very much localized with many engineers and a lot of competencies. So we are able to have a proximity to our customers which others may not have.
What can be expected from you in upcoming years?
I think clearly we want to establish ourselves on the market in India. We have had a start. It was not always easy, because when you start something new, it's never easy. But we really want now to build on the job we have done. We want to use the opportunities given by the market, and we want to be really present on the metro market in India.
Okay, what is your strategy to tackle the competition in your sector?
But in India, the customers are all public customers. So all award is done under the Public Procurement Act, which means fundamentally you have to qualify, you have to give a compliant bid, and you have to be price competitive. Okay. So we are working a lot on developing solutions for India and on working on our competitiveness to be present in India.
How Alstom can improve the railway signaling system?
I think we are very much present in metro systems. I think here there is no doubt about it. In mainline, our competitors are much more present as they are today. But to globally, Indian Rail has plans to upgrade the signaling system in order to improve speed and security, safety of the people. And clearly, with our CBTC solutions, we will be part of the game.
What is your outlook for jobs in India?
But today, Alstom has already set up of close to 5,000 people in India. We have 4 factories, 2 big engineering centers, project centers, and we are continuously recruiting talents in the country for our Indian operations at a pace of 100-120 people per year, since per month, since more than 1 year and a half.
So what are the expansion plan for city facility?
So today in India we have four industrial facilities, Sri City for metros, Coimbatore for components, Madhepura for locomotive, and Texmaco, or former Texmaco in Calcutta for car body shells. We are today expanding our Calcutta facility. We are multiplying by 2.5 our Coimbatore capacity, and we are multiplying by 2 our Sri City capacity. With this new capacity, Sri City will become the biggest metro factory in India.
What is your opinion about Metro Rail News magazine?
I am looking at the magazines. I'm always very interested to read about what my competitors are doing, because the most important thing is to know what the others are doing.
Yeah. Would you like to share something with us related to technology?
Regarding technology?
Yeah.
I think today India is really putting a lot of accent in acquiring technology, in developing technology. And one of the strengths of Alstom is that we are not only in India to use the capability in India, but we bring a lot of knowledge, a lot of training, a lot of competency to our people. And I'm extremely proud about this.
So the government instituted the Make in India.
Yeah.
How do you think it is helpful for Alstom?
I think Make in India is for me a key asset for our company. Because India, Alstom is in India since more than 100 years in power and in other activities. And we always had an approach that we address India from inside of India. So we consider ourselves as being the Indian branch of a global company. And we compete against Indian company as per Indian rules. For us, any initiative which gives visibility, which gives support to Indian company is most welcome. And on top of it, I am personally strictly convinced that the sustainability of our activity in India goes through the use of Indian capability and Indian talents.
So how Alstom bringing digitization in metros and railway?
Digitalization is today part of all the control system, of course, but is also in our design activity, it's in our internal process, it's in our manufacturing activity with a 4.0 industrial wave, which is today implemented in our factories. Digital is everywhere. Not only what the customers see, but also the way we run and we do our business. Okay.
What is the vision and mission of Alstom for metros and railway?
I think clearly our vision is first to be very agile, to adapt to the needs of our customers, to be close to our customers. Then the technological breakthrough is clearly towards better efficiency in electricity, to reuse, to have maximum use of electricity. Also new technologies like hydrogen trains, like fuel cell trains are clearly part of the future. The focus will be, beside digital, on energy efficiency.
Mr. Alain, thank you for giving your time.
Most welcome. It's a pleasure to discuss with you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.